गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ बिजनेस एनालिटिक्स यूजिंग पाइथन, दिस इज आवर फोर्थ लेक्चर एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अगेन द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। दिस होल यूनिट बिलोंग्स टू द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। फर्स्ट टाइम यू आर स्टडिंग द सब्जेक्ट रिलेटेड टू द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज, सो दैट्स वाई I am focusing more on to the basics of programming language. How, what are the basics, how you can write the basics, and what are the basic things that is related or that is helpful to understand actually this particular programming language. That's why I am stretching my syllabus or my lectures onto the basics of this programming language. Okay, in previous lecture we have discussed the bitwise operators. Okay, unary operators. Now we will discuss further. Okay, today we will start our discussion with the logical operators. Logical operators are what? That is logical AND operator, logical OR operator, logical NOT operator. Okay, if you have remembered, then you can associate these things with the bitwise operators. In previous lecture, we have discussed bitwise OR, bitwise AND, bitwise NOT, bitwise XOR. Okay, and the operations or the truth table that we have discussed in previous lecture is same as that of this particular topic, that is logical operator. Okay, logical operator is what? You will write double AND operator, AND percent ampersand operator. But while you have studied the bitwise operator, shift bitwise operators, that time you simply write A AND, simple AND operator or ampersand operator, simple OR operator and simple NOR operator or the exponentiation operator for the XOR operator, bitwise XOR. Here you will, first of all, we'll discuss logical AND operators. The truth table will be same. Okay, is used to simulate, evaluate two conditions or expressions with relational operators if expressions on both the sides, left and the right of the logical operators, are true, then the whole expression is true. For example, if we have an expression A is greater than B and B is greater than C, the meaning of this is what? In this particular expression, both of the conditions must be true. If any of the condition is false, for example, A is greater than B is false, then no need to proceed further. If the condition of A is greater than equal to B is true, then you will move further and check the condition for B and C. Whether B is greater than C, if B is greater than C, means after the whole expression, if both of the expressions or the whole expression is true, only if the answer will be true. Okay, that is, if B is greater than and A is greater than C, A is greater than B and B is greater than C. For example, if A is greater than B, then for example it is true, then you will check whether B is greater than C. Now it depends, if B is greater than C, definitely your A will be greater. Okay, that is, if B is greater than A and C in this particular case. Okay, logical OR operator is used to simultaneously evaluate two conditions or expressions with relational operator. If one or both the expressions of the logical operator is true, listen to me very carefully. In previous operator or logical AND operator, you must check whether the both conditions are true or not. But in this logical OR operator, either of the condition is true. If, for example, if one or both the expressions of the logical operators are true, then the whole expression will be true. If, for example, if we have an expression A is greater than B or B is greater than C, then the whole expression is true if either B is greater than or A or B is greater than C. If A is greater than B, okay, if either B is greater than A or B is greater than C, so in that case, answer will be true. Logical NOT operator, in this particular case, you must have a single expression. Okay, takes a single expression and negate the value of that expression. Logical NOT produce a 0 if the expression evaluate to a non-zero values, and produce a 1 if the expression produce a 0. In other words, is just reverse the value of the expression. For example, a equal to 10, b equal to, b is equal to negation of a. Now the value of b is equal to 0. Okay, the value of a is not 0. Therefore, not of a is what? 0. The value of not a is assigned to b. Hence, that will be the result. So this is all about the logical operators. First one is logical AND operator, second one is logical OR operator, and third one is logical NOT operator. Next one is membership and identity operator. Python supports two types of membership operator, IN and NOT IN. These operators test for membership in a sequence such as string, list or tuple. These are the data type. We have already discussed string. In this particular lecture, we will discuss lists, tuples or dictionary also. Okay, IN operator is what? This is the membership operator. IN operator means the operator returns true if a variable is found in the specified sequence and false otherwise. For example, you are having 1, 2, 3, 4. Simply asking, someone is asking from you A in that particular list. If that particular one is in that list, answer will be true. If that particular element is not in the list, that means not in operator will be there. Correspondingly, the answer will reflect. Okay. In operator is what? Operator returns true if a variable is found in the specified sequence and false otherwise. For example, A in num returns 1 if A is a member of nums. Not in operator is what? Opposite of this one. If the A is not in the member of none, then only it will return the true. Okay, you can read this line. Operator returns true if a variable is not found in the specified sequence and false otherwise. For example, A not in num means A is not in the number, then it will return 1 if A is not in the number of nums. Identity operators are is operator, is not operator. What is it? It returns true if operands or values on both sides of the operators points to the same object. And false otherwise. For example, if A is B, A is B means what? It returns true if and only if the value of both A and B are same. A is B means if, for example, you are having A is equal to 10, then definitely if you want to retrieve yes, then B must be equal to 10. Or the same, whatsoever the value of A may be, that will be the value of B also. In that case only, you can say that D of A is same as that of ID of B. Okay, ID of A is same as that of the ID of B. Is not operator is what? When the values are not same. Returns true if operands or values on both of sides of the operator does not match. Okay, so likewise, you will get the results. This is the membership and identity operators. Next is expressions. We have already discussed what are the expressions are. Any legal combination of symbols like variables, constants and operators that represents a value. In Python, expression must have at least one operand. We have already discussed unary operator. Okay, that means at least one operand must be there. And it can have one or more operators. On evaluating an expression, we get a value. Operand is the value on which operator is applied. For example, constant of expression. Constant expression is one. You simply write A is equal to B plus C. Whatsoever they, what will be the value of A, then B, then C. For example, example is 8 plus 9 minus 2. 8 is the value of A, 9 is the value of B, 2 is the value of C. Now we are not talking about the value may vary. Constant expression is this one. Constant means that this will be same. 8 plus 9 minus 2. Answer will be also, it gives the constant. Integral expression is what? A is equal to 10. This is the integral expression. 10 is what? This is the integer number. And it stores in where? In A variable. Like floating point expression. You simply write one that produces floating point results. For example, A multiplied by B divided by 2. Definitely, for example, the value of A is equal to 1, value of B is equal to 2. Multiplication of 1 multiplied by 2 equal to 2 divided by 2. Answer will be 2.0, 1.0. Okay. Value of A is equal to 1. Value of B is equal to 2. Value of B is equal to 3. Answer will, resultant will be 3 divided by 2. Answer will be 1.5. that will be the floating point expression. Likewise, relational operator. Relational expression is what? That returns either true or false, depending upon the expression. For example, C is equal to A is greater than B. If A, the value of A is greater than B, then definitely it will give the true, else false. Then is logical expression. We have already discussed all such types of logical expression, bitwise expression, assignment expression. We have already done these things. Now, you should know what kinds of expressions that we may encounter while programming in Python. Logical expression is what? One that combines two or more relational expression and return a value as true or false. Example is what? A is greater than B. And Y is not equal to 0. This is what the logical expressions. Bitwise expressions are what? Once that manipulates data a bit level, example A equal, X equal to Y and Z. Okay, that is bitwise. Bitwise means the first truth table A and B 00011011. I have already told you about the answer of Y and Z is what? If if both of the inputs are high, output will be high, else output will be low, means zero. Assignment expression is what? One, the assign a value to a variable, example C equal to A plus B. What is the value of A? What is the value of B? It depends upon, after the calculation of the results, you will get the C equal to 10. C equal to 10 means you will get the answer, like 5 plus 5. Next is operators on string. In operators on string, you simply write print missile man of India. You all know that is Sir APJ Abdul Kalam. So it will print missile man of India hyphen, because you have written missile man of India within the double quotes. Then plus, plus means now you are concatenating the two strings. Then again you write within the double quotes hyphen Sir APJ Abdul Kalam. So it will comes into the console as an result. Print hello multiplied by 5. I have already told you that hello means is what? It is a string. Multiplication of 5 means, it doesn't mean H multiplied by 5, E multiplied by 5. The meaning of what? Meaning of this is what? Hello will be printed 5 times. You can write like this, str equal to hello. In single quotes you have written hello, then print str plus 4. Str plus 4 means, okay, simply str is what? Hello. Plus 4 means it will, plus will concatenate this 4. So output will be hello 4. This is the output. And while you write str multiplied by 5, that means it will repeat the string 5 times, or the number of times whatsoever the value is given with this at the send to this one. Okay, this is the operators on string. Next is slice operations on strings. Slice operations on string means just simply in a layman language, I am telling you. In layman language, what you can say that, for example, GALGOTIAS, Galgotias, UNIVERSITY, University. If you want to take a slice, if you want to take some alphabets from those Galgotias University, so you will provide the range within the expression. How we can provide the range? Like this. Just leave this particular theory. You simply focus in this example. This is what str equal to Python is easy. We have just simply written within this single quotes, we have written Python is easy and exclamation sign, exclamation sign, exclamation sign. Output, in output, this exactly string will be printed onto the console. Then after that, we have write print str. With the help of this, it is printed onto the Python is easy. And after that, you have write print str and you have provide the index. This is the index value. 0 means what? P. So output will be P. Next is print str 3 to 9. 3 to 9 means, listen, this is P is for 0, index 1, Y, index 2, T, index 3, X. Now it will start from H. Means 3 to 9. 3, 4, 5, then space 4, 5, 6, then space 7, 8 and 9. So from H, O, N, space I, S, space E, A. These are the words, or you can say that this is the slicing operator. How you can slice the string this way. Okay, so with the help of this, you can take like this one, str 4 colon. 4 means string will start from 4. Next is str index value is minus 1. Minus 1 means now the particular string that is to be given into the str, it is to be in the reverse order. It is to be printed in the reverse order. You can use the string or any of the strings you can take. And write like this, the words is to be printed onto the console in a reverse order, or the characters is to be printed onto the reverse order. Okay, so you can use this one. We have already discussed str multiplication of 2, 2 times the string will be printed. Okay, then str plus, isn't it? Means string is what? Python is easy, exclamation symbol, then plus is a concatenation symbol, and within the double quotes, what is it? It isn't it. That is to be printed onto the console. This is all about the slicing operator. Okay, we have already written this particular theory over here. You can read the theory and execute the programs like this. Next is list. List is what? List are the most versatile data type of Python language. A list contains of items separated by commas and enclosed within a square bracket. Listen to me very carefully. All the elements within the list must be enclosed within the square bracket. Okay, like this. List equal to, in within the square brackets you have written a comma bc comma 78 comma 1.23. So this is a single list where contains the 5 elements. Okay, values stored in a list are accessed using index. Listen to me very carefully. Again, I am telling you, the index will start from the 0 itself. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. Okay, I have also written over here index of the first element being 0 and n minus 1. Anything which is to be started from the 0, the length will be automatically decremented by 1. So the range will be 0 to n minus 1 as that of the last element, where n is the total number of elements in the list. Like strings, you can also use the slicing, concatenation and repetitions operation on the list. The point is same again. Print list, list will be A, then BC, then 78, then 1.23. List, this is, I have already mentioned each and everything with comments, that print first element of the list. Print element starting from second till third, this is 1, 2, 3. 2 colon, print element starting from third element. It will start from third and last, third to last. Multiplication of 2, that means repeat the string 2 times, like this, ABC 78123, ABC 78123. This is what list plus list 2. What is list 2? You simply write list 2, the 2 elements D and 78. Means after 1.23, D and 78 will be concatenated over here. So this is the concept of list. You can say that list is also a kind of data type that you are used in Python. Okay. And one thing that you should under that you shouldn't forget, that list consists of items separated by commas and enclosed within the square bracket. Okay, this is all about the list. Then tuple. Tuple is similar to the list, as it also consists of a number of values separated by commas, same but enclosed within the parentheses. In list, what we have discussed, list, all the elements of the list will be, or the values, or the numbers of values which is to be separated by the commas and enclosed within the, what we have said, square bracket. But in tuples, it is enclosed within the parentheses. The main difference between the list and tuple is that you can change the value in a list but not in the tuple. If you have fixed the values, if you have defined a tuple, you cannot change the values for the tuples. But in list, you can change or you can modify the values. This means that while tuple is a read-only data type, list is not. So this is the difference between the list and tuple. Okay, you can modify the elements, value of the elements within the list, but can't change or modify the values within the tuple. The examples are same as that of the previously we have discussed. You just simply write the examples and you can run the programs. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can discuss with me. This is the final, this is the dictionary. Dictionary is what? Python's dictionary stores in key value pairs. Okay, you just simply focus over here. Dict means dictionary, equal to item colon chocolate, price colon 100. That means it's a key value pair. Key is what? Item. value is what? Chocolate. Key is what? Price. Value is what? 100. How you will print this one? Print dictionary and curly and square brackets, simply write item. Print dictionary within the square bracket, simply write price, and it will give the output. What is the output? Value will be the output. Chocolate and 100 will be the output. The Python's dictionary stores data in a key value pair. Key value are usually strings, and value can be of any data type. Key value pair are enclosed within the curly braces. Listen one thing. Again, I am telling you, you must know how your elements will be enclosed. First of all, we have discussed list. The elements is to be enclosed within the square bracket. Then we have discussed tuples. Elements is to be enclosed within the parentheses. And in dictionary, again, element is to be enclosed within the curly braces. Each key value pair separated from the other uses using a column. Okay. To access any value in the dictionary, you just need to specify its key in the square bracket like this. Dictionary, square bracket, item or price. Item and price is what? This is the key values. Basically, dictionary are used for fast retrieval of data. Now, this is all about the dictionary. Next is type conversion. Type conversion is what? You simply write within the double quotes 20 plus double quotes 30. Answer will be 2030. Not 20 plus 30 is equal to 50, because it acts as a string. When the values is of string type and you are using plus symbol as a concatenation, the output will be in the concatenated form of the string, not the addition of the two string. For example, int 2, then plus int 3. Now the answer will be 5, because int is what? 2. Int is what? 3. It will give you the answer 5. Likewise, you can use the functions. You can read the functions and description within this particular table. Int x is what? Convert x to a string. Long x is what? Convert x to a long integer. Likewise, tuple x is convert x to a tuple. Like this, hex x, convert an integer to a hexadecimal number. CHRX, convert an integer to a character. Likewise, okay? You can use this one, and you can use these functions into your programs. If you have any doubt, you can discuss with me. Okay. This is the last topic of your this particular for the day, that is typecasting versus type correction. In the last slides, we have done explicitly conversion of a value from one data type to the another. In last slides, we have already discussed these things. Okay. In previous slide, this is a known as typecasting. Okay. However, in most of the programming languages, including Python, there is an implicit conversion of data types either during compilation or during runtime. This is also known as type correction. For example, in an expression that has integer and floating point number, like 21 plus 2.1, it gives 23.1. The compiler will automatically convert the integer into floating point number so that fractional part is not lost. Okay, this is all about the type casting versus type correction. Okay, that's all for today's lecture from my side. If you have any doubt, if you have any query, you can ask me. Okay, you can follow the URLs of this one, W3Schools and tutorialpoints.com, and you can refer these books that I have already mentioned in this textbooks and reference book section. Okay, thank you so much for the day. Thank you so much.